Hello and welcome to a video demonstration showcasing how Power BI integrates with Alteryx to provide an end-to-end solution from data preparation and analysis in Alteryx to data visualization via Power BI. Now, if you don't know what Power BI is, it's a data visualization tool that allows you to turn raw data into a more digestible visual output for business members. What we've often found is that messy data is very often not in the correct format to be ready for visualization. Now what we propose is that Alteryx is the very best tool in the market for preparing, transforming, and cleansing data. And so, quite logically, we propose the solution of using Alteryx to transform your data into a standard that is suitable for these visualization tools to be output to the business. Now, you can see here, I mean, I've got Alteryx Designer open and I have three separate workflows open in separate tabs. Now, what I would call these are the three different stages of Alteryx and Power BI integration, and I will take you through each and every one step by step. So firstly, you can see here that we have a very simple workflow open. We are reading in two files, a customer's CSV file and a transactions XML file. We're utilizing some data preparation tools to do some things like drop unwanted columns, change some data types, cleansing some data and filtering it. And then we utilize a join tool to join these two data sets together. And here you can see we've got an output tool which is outputting to an Excel spreadsheet. So this is the first quite simple stage. And it is quite simple because all you need to do is go over here and open up Power BI Desktop. This method utilizes Power BI Desktop. And here you would click Get Data, Excel, and locate to the exact location that you output that Excel spreadsheet from your Alteryx workflow. So here it's already open to the folder that I need, and it's this Customers and Transactions Excel workbook. Now, I would open this, but I've already done that previously. And you can configure a dashboard within Power BI Desktop, very similar to the one I have open here, where I'm looking at some total sales by city and customer segment for my data set. Now, this is, there are some limitations to this. The first of which being that any user that this is shared with must have Power BI Desktop installed in order to view the dashboard that we've created here. Now, obviously that isn't ideal. Some users may not have Power BI Desktop installed, and such you might be limited to who you can share this information with. Another such limitation is that there is little user control, as any user that this is shared with has access to this Power BI Desktop editor view. You can see here we've got the dashboard on the left, but here we also have all of the editor options on the right. So potentially I could, as a business user that's been shared this information with, I could accidentally, of course, click some of the options on this editor view and then change the dashboard such that it's broken. And obviously we don't want that. Now, thankfully, there is a second option, and this leads us quite swiftly onto the second stage of the Alteryx Power BI integration. And that is, if I open this here and I open up this second workflow, and this method solves the two problems that we previously mentioned in the first stage. And now I'll detail exactly why that is later on. But you can see here that I've got a very similar workflow. In fact, it's pretty much identical apart from the output. The tools that I've highlighted on the screen now are completely identical, so we're not actually changing any of the files that we're reading in or the preparation that we're doing with this data. What we are changing is the output and exactly how we configure that. So you can see here what I've got is I've got a month tag that I've introduced, and I've created a local file onto my PC. Now, this doesn't really make sense as of yet, but I will detail exactly why this is when we go on to the third stage, which will talk about a use case in monthly reporting. But for now, we'll stick on this, and you can see here that I have, instead of an Excel spreadsheet, we're utilizing this tool here, which is downloadable from the Alteryx gallery, and then it appears within the connectors category over here. So you can see it's this tool here, it's called Power BI Output, and it does exactly what it says, really. It writes data sets to Microsoft Power BI. So now, yeah, this tool utilizes an API to connect directly to the online Power BI cloud service, and it subverts the requirement of using an Excel spreadsheet as an in-between step in this process. So what I can do is, as you can see here, after logging in using my Power BI credentials, I'm shown this exact configuration window. I can change the workspace that I'm outputting, so I can actually output this to my personal workspace if I'd want to, but as this is data that I'm sharing within the business, then I'm going to output this to my Continuum shared workspace. I can put in a dataset name and table name, and I can, in this case, I will be creating a new dataset. And so if I run this, which I've already done, I can then go on to the online Power BI service, and you can see here that I am faced with this exact window. And you can see here, this is the dataset that I previously uploaded onto the Continuum shared workspace. Now what I can do here, to create a dashboard out of this data, I can now click on these three dots and click Create Report. I've done this in the other window, and I can create a dashboard very similar to how I would do in the Power BI desktop version. But now what I can do is I can save this, and I alter report name, demo, and I have saved that report. Here we go, it's just loading in. And now what I can do is I can actually pin this to a dashboard. I will create a new dashboard called demo, and I will pin live. And now I will go to this dashboard to see what that looks like. So you can see here that I'm faced with the exact same, pretty much, dashboard as I created within the Power BI desktop version. What I have done is I've created this month filter. That will make a lot more sense when I go into the stage three of the integration. But you can see here that I have options in the top here to share this within the business. I can grant access to individuals with their email address. So for example, if I wanted to, if I wanted to give my colleague Ben access, then I could do so. I can also write an optional message, and here I have options to allow him to share the dashboard, perhaps I don't want him to build content using the underlying datasets, maybe I do, and then I won't send him an email notification as well. So here I have options to share to email addresses, and I also have the option over here to share that within Teams. So you have a lot more dynamic shareability within the business, which solves one of the problems that we mentioned previously, because in the previous stage, every user that you share this with would have to have Power BI installed. Now the other problem that we mentioned was the lack of user control, because when you share within Power BI Desktop, the user that you share with is presented with the exact same view that you do, containing all of the editor window. And now you can see here that I don't have that, because I've created a report and then pinned that onto a dashboard on the online Power BI service. So that is stage two. You can see that there are definitely some improvements on stage one, utilizing this Power BI output tool, which uses an API to connect directly. And now I'll just open up the third workflow and go on to stage three. Now this workflow demonstrates the third and final stage of the integration. Instead of just focusing on the Power BI output tool over here alone, what we've done is we've applied it to a monthly sales reporting use case. Again, you can see here that the data preparation on the left-hand side of the workflow is identical as the previous workflows, but instead, again, we've got some slightly different outputs which we've configured differently, and I'll just go through that now. So firstly, these formula tools are changing the sales data, and they are changing the month tag from 2021-01 to 2021-02. Now what this is essentially doing is simulating new sales data from the next reporting period compared to the previous workflow. So in this one, we've got January 2021, and we've got the sales data that's in these files, but I've changed those numbers and I've added the tag to be February. So what this is doing is just simulating the next month in reporting. Whereas in reality, you know, this change would actually come from the input data itself, but for demo purposes, I've just changed the values using these two formula tools. So it's exactly the same. Again, you can see that we are creating a local file of the date when we run the workflow. And now what this directory tool here is doing is it points to the same location that this local file that we've created is saved to. Now with the workflow set up as it is currently, the first time we run the process, the 2021-02 CSV file that was produced here, it doesn't exist within the folder. And so all of the sales data that comes out, that goes into the join here, will come out of the left output. And as you can see, that is being pushed over towards the Power BI output tool, and therefore being pushed online to the Power BI web service. And then in parallel here, we can see that at the same time as that file, that data is being pushed out online, we're also creating this local file. Now, this means that when the workflow is run a second time, this 2021-02 CSV file does not exist within this folder. Oh, excuse me, it does exist in this folder. And so the directory tool pulls that through, and then all of the sales data comes out of the join output as a result. And you can see here that we're not actually outputting that join anywhere. And it doesn't go to the Power BI output tool. You can see here that we have changed the configuration of the Power BI output tool. So it's no longer writing a new data set, but instead it's appending the rows to the table that we've already created. Now what this does is this stacks the old data from this data set and table on top of the new data that we are pushing to the Power BI online, so that we have a full view of January and February stacked on top of each other. Now the layout of this workflow ensures that new data for a given month is only appended to the existing data set when the process is run for the first time. Now this avoids duplicating any important data that you've already pushed to the Power BI online service and ensures that the dashboard represents the correct data. So for example, if I was to not have this fail-safe join implemented, if I run this once, which I'll actually do now, and then I run it again, then I will stack that data that I've already pushed online again, therefore duplicating my data. That's not going to actually represent any real outputs when I view that in the dashboard. So I'm just running the workflow here, and I'll show you exactly what that looks like online on the Power BI dashboard that we've already created. So here we go. We've output the local file, and we've pushed it online using the Power BI output tool. Now if I go over here, we can see if I refresh this dashboard, like so, now, as you can see, after refreshing this dashboard, you can see that the filter has changed slightly. I now have the option to select 2021-02 as well as 2021-01. So here, the dashboard has changed slightly because you can see that we've now got different values for all of the sales. That's because it's showing me all of the data that I've got on the dashboard currently. So it's showing me January and February stacked on top of one another. But with this filter, what I can do is I can select one or the other, and the dashboard changes subsequently. Now, to demonstrate what happens if I run this workflow again with the current configuration of how things are set up here, I will do this again. And now, because the local file has already been created at the end of this workflow when I previously ran it, the directory tool should pick that up, and we should not have any data being pushed online. So yes, you can see here that zero records are being pushed through to the Power BI output tool, and there we go. All 430 records are being pushed out of the join, which is going nowhere. So there's nothing that's being done with this data. We're not duplicating any records, and we're making sure that the visualization that we output to any of our business users is correct and represents the data that we want it to. So there we are. If you're interested in finding out how your business can streamline your Power BI data visualization using Alteryx to prepare your data so it's fit for those visualization tools, then please visit our website to find out more.